What's up guys, Dr. Zeezy here, and today we are planning to do a Q&A video. You guys asked the questions, so I decided to answer them. To be honest guys, there were so many of those questions, so I could not definitely answer all of them, but I've picked and choose a couple of them that I think might be important. How about let's get to it. So SD Nisar Ahmed has said, hello Dr. Zeezy, it's really good to see you, thanks for this video. So can you put some light on internship details? In which department should be practiced and in their specific months? I think I came up with my video last time and I spoke about how important internship is. So they had more questions regarding what kind of rotations are acceptable by the GMC. I found a really cool link which describes a little bit about the internship and what rotations are expected. I'll put the link in the description. Ideally, internship should be for a period of 1 year duration of continuous practice. That means you can't have gaps. And even if you do have gaps, you only can take around 20 days or something. And in this 1 year period, you should at least do 3 months in medicine and 3 months in surgery. So a lot of people had questions regarding, you know, what is medicine and what is surgery. So certain subjects can be considered as medicine. So cardiology, respiratory medicine, renal medicine, gastroenterology, neurology, all can be considered as medicine. And things like general surgery, orthopedics, urology, plastic surgery, even gyn and obs, all of them will be accepted as surgical rotation. So you don't have to only do medicine or general surgery. There are a lot of subspecialties, so yes, GMC can accept any of those. It's a really cool website and it's gonna dive a lot deeper into what is necessary for an internship, so you can have a look in that. Further on, he has asked, as you mentioned about the cost, can you tell us the approximate payment which might be in FY2? Yes, okay. So if you look at this website called IMG Connect, they have actually given all the details of the different types of specialties and what their pay is. So if you look at FY1 and FY2, generally the pay for FY1 is around 28,000 per year, and for FY2 it's £33,000. Approximately. Mind you, all these salaries that I'm going to be talking about, these are before tax. UK is an expensive country and some of the taxes are quite high. So for example, if you look at 28,000 for FY1, you can expect anywhere between 1900 to £2,000 take home every month, and at 33,345, in that case you might roughly get around 2400 to 2600. If you're more interested, you can look at specialty training, they get up to 39 to 53. And as you go higher in the grade, the pay scale increases. Now, consultants get approximately around 82,000 to 110,000 per year. This is just their basic salary. So yes, salary for FY2 might be around 2,600. Might not be a lot to begin with. If you stay and if you work up the ladder, then I think you can definitely get a good take-home salary. Finally, last question, how much does it cost to live in UK while doing FY2? Monthly expenses flat. You have to understand that UK is one of the most expensive countries to live in. In fact, it's the 7th most expensive country in Western Europe. It also depends on where you're living in UK. If you're living in London, things are going to be very expensive. But when you move towards the suburbs, things might be a little bit cheaper than living in London. So if you're looking for a studio apartment, for example, in London, studio apartments can go anywhere between $1,000 and above. So if you want to stay for something cheaper, then you can rent a room in an apartment, so you'll be sharing a room with other mates. But if you go outside London, you might be able to find a place for like around 800 to 900 pounds. Food can be cheap if you're cooking at home. Big groceries in UK, such as Tesco and Asda, they have promotions and discounts going on. You can always buy things in bulk and cook at home. Of course, when you're going out, once again, it depends where you're going to go. Are you going to central London? Then things will be more expensive. If you're going to go somewhere in the outskirts, then things are going to be cheaper. So of course, you can save money, but it depends on how your lifestyle is and how you're going to be living. If I wanted to do internship in Russia, should I come back to my country? So I explained about this in my previous video where I told you guys to come back to your country and become a doctor first, where I had a few people asking me questions that if they can do internship in the university or the country that they graduated in. So as I told you, there is an acceptable pattern that I just spoke about. You have to make sure, number one, if that university is going to give you that kind of an acceptable pattern that UK expects. So if that is the case, then yes, you can do that. And number two, you have to make sure that UK is accepting the internship from that country. The best thing to do would be just send an email to the GMC and find out. Because it's better to be sure rather than be unsure and go through the entire year of internship. In my case, personally, I wanted to come back to my country and I wanted to get registered here first. This was just a personal thing, so I did not have a problem in spending some time getting this and then going to UK. Dr. J, where are you now and did you migrate? So a lot of you guys are asking me questions if I'm gone to UK. No, so no, I have not migrated to UK first. I literally just became a registered doctor in my own country. So at the same time, corona pandemic is happening and I have certain things to attend to in my home country. So I have pushed going to UK for a bit, but I'm still enjoying loving being a doctor. Hey doc, what kind of a student have you been from the beginning? Were you like super studious and studying all the time? Because I'm pretty average, would I make it? Thank you for that question. First of all, no, I was never super studious. And would you make it? Definitely, my friend. To be honest, I have always been an all-rounder. So I used to play hard and study hard. So in simple terms, I knew things that were important to me. So whenever there was an exam or whenever there was something coming up, I would put all my time and effort into that one thing and make sure I do it well. You must have seen this through my previous videos. But when I'm done with that, I always make sure I go out, enjoy life a bit, because being a doctor is not just about studying and, you know, going through and breaking head about it. You do this because this is one part of your life, but also make sure you enjoy. Definitely you'll make it. Make a balance, enjoy life, pursue other interests other than medicine, and I think you'll be amazing. Another question people asked me was police clearance certificate. So everybody's asking me where you should get a police clearance certificate. Everyone's so confused. It's quite simple, guys. Every country has its own procedures. Certain countries you have to do it online, whereas certain countries you have to go to the local police station and find out what is the procedure of applying. Now, so if you're not sure how to get your police clearance certificate, you can go to gov.uk website and you can go to the section of police clearance certificate, criminal record certificate, and check for apply. When you do that, you can find guidance on application process for the criminal records just for overseas. So whatever the country you are, they will guide you. So if anybody is from, for example, Bangladesh, you can find out the procedure of getting your police clearance certificate from here. So as I said, life is also about having fun, and my channel is gonna reflect just that. So the next video is gonna be about some of my favorite movies that I love to watch. So be sure to check out for that video. This is your boy, Dr. Zeezy. See you in the next video. Take it easy. Peace.